So ever since I was a kid and like fell in love with music, I've obviously written songs myself for years, and but I didn't really want to be Callum Beattie. I wanted to be in a band. I love going into a studio with other writers. Sometimes it, like, so when I first moved to London, I got chucked in a room with all these different folk, and they all had loads of different styles and different things. That was all right for a wee while, but I don't know, I like to go into a room with people that share the same enthusiasm for the style of music that I like. I love indie bands, so everything from Arcade Fire to Kings of Leon, anything that's upbeat and got a wee bit of balls about it, do you know what I mean? You'd be surprised how many people that don't really realise how a song's actually made. The reason I write songs is for the right reasons, which is, it's self-therapy. It's like talking about your upbringing, your traumas, your things that you in your life that you've suffered from, and if you, it's almost like I'm telling everybody things that have happened to me in my life, and I get them off my chest, but I put them in music. My dad brought me up pretty much on his own, and after school every night he had a cupboard of magical records. He had records for The Clash, to Queen, to Elton John, to Led Zeppelin, Jethro Tull, just weird stuff as well that I thought was rubbish, but you know, it was an education, and I just fell in love with music, and then I begged him to get me a wee guitar and started writing songs, and I played this song to him, and he goes, "Who's that?" And I was like, "That's my song." And I could see in his eyes, it was like that glint thing where he's like, "You've got to be joking." And he goes, "Seriously, whose song's that?" And I said, I just wrote it, it's my song. And I just made my whole life about writing songs, and that's what my life's been for the last 17 years.
Girl and the moon, how they lie the night together, disappear too soon. I wish I had the strength to save her on a thousand dreams that we share, with broken whispers floating on a breeze, dancing, twisted, lost forever. Light the hell. Bless on it, pray. Let the winds take me away till I find a brighter sun. I'll go dance, 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 dancing with fools. Yeah, I'll go. The tide is rolling and making mystery. Where she goes when I get lonely and unknown destiny. Torn apart and vacant shadows floating on the breeze. Dancing, twisted, lost forever. Like the helpless honey prey. Let the winds take. Find a brighter sun.
I've got to say, I think that vocals are good class. I know it's got a bit of spillage on it, but I just wonder.
I would definitely keep it.
That's kind of like a song I put on the record because I knew my dad would like it, because it's quite like Pink Floyd-esque, ethereal sort of. It's one of those songs that's like you should just sit back and listen to, and it takes you on a journey. You know, it's not really meant to be a big single or an instant like, oh wow, smash hook. I mean, the intro, it's an arty song, not a charty. You need to basically give up your whole life to be a musician. It has to be a lifestyle thing. You can't half-arse it. You've got to, it's all or nothing, you know. And so I managed to sort of build a fan base and all that. And then when it came to recording this record, I thought rather than doing what everybody else does in the industry and get session musicians that play for a million different other singer-songwriters or whatever, I thought I'll just get my pals. So I think I hit the jackpot, to be honest with you, because every single person is a very beautiful human and they bring out the best in me, I think, and hopefully I bring out the best in them. So I couldn't be happier. All the graft and the sweat and blood and tears and all that, it just feels worth it. And we've sold nearly 3,000 tickets for the gig I'm going to be playing this week, which is actually mental. I think it's only when you're standing on the stage and you're thinking, holy shit, man, like, all these people know these songs and they know you, and they treat you like you're fucking John Lennon when you're just like some wee dude for the arse end of nowhere just writing some tunes in his bedroom. Vandals is a song that actually formed the shape of the record. As soon as I'd wrote it, 2 days later I wrote another song called Mammy, and then it just kind of like, all the other songs I'd written for a year and a half before then just kind of got put to the sidelines, and I was like, right, this is it, this is what I want the record to sound like, which is just all real instrumentation, which is a rare thing these days. If you listen to the radio, 99.9% of the songs, they're no real drums. We've managed to do that, so we try and keep it live. And it's like a punk record, but singable. You can sing along to it, and that's important to me. And I think I nailed it with that song, I think.
we try that.
I'm constantly writing songs, you know, every day basically in my head, and different things I'm marking down. So the next few months I'll go and write an album basically, and then we'll go into the studio, I'll present it how I hear it, and then if anyone's got any ideas of how we can make them better or take it in a different direction, and then we just try and, with the budget we've got, make the best record we can make, you know. We base everything on the philosophy of love, and I know it sounds cheesy and sort of like it's a bit contrived or that, but really it is that simple. Heart Stops Beating, again, like after Vandals, I wrote that probably the next again week. And it was just instantly, I was like, that sounds like a single. Or literally, it's one of these songs you just got lucky, and I wrote it in like 15 minutes. It was just like, and I wanted that sort of like anthemic sort of stadium drum beat. And it just wrote itself, that's all I can say really. And I love it. It's probably the one song that I feel like's at your funeral, everybody's gonna talk about your music. What song do you want them to play? I'd probably say that, because I feel like it's the coolest record I've ever written. It's about like that initial feeling when you meet somebody and you go, well, you just know instantly like you're probably going to be part of my life for a long time. Do you know what I mean? Not like necessarily falling in love, but just that way where you go like, I just think you're a very special person and you're always going to be part of me in my journey in life. You know what I mean? You meet a lot of people like that, right? I certainly do. Well, when you know, eh? It's not an easy industry, you know, and you need support mentally, somebody to give you a cuddle to say it's going to be all right, and actually genuinely look out for you and care for you as a person, you know? I didn't feel like I ever had that before. I felt like it was a job for people. I got that now and I'm grateful for it. Erin is the Young Traditional Musician of the Year in Scotland, and so she gives that sort of variety to us and to the recordings. It's a great wee touch. So Jason's my guitar player. He's a very loving, what you see is what you get guy. Apart from his football team, I love absolutely everything about Nairn. He's a great drummer. We've got Johnny Madden on bass. He's a great songwriter. And we've got Gus Harrower on the keys. He kind of like helps musical direct. They're all brilliant, like. We'll be right back. I hope we can just keep snowballing what we're doing and get more and more people out there to listen to our tunes and buy into the whole aesthetic of like being a tribe and community and love and, you know, trying to change other people's lives through music.